I am speaking to you from the cabinet room at 10 Downing Street. This morning, the British ambassador in Berlin handed the German government a final note stating that unless we heard from them by 11 o'clock, that they were prepared at once to withdraw their troops from Poland, a state of war would exist between us, and that consequently this country is at war with Germany.
Well, I was 6 when war broke out, and I remember my father and mother listening to the radio and the time when it was said. After that, nothing happened, as you know, for a while, and then the Blitz started. And that was when we had a shelter in the garden, and we used to sleep down there, my sister and I, in bunks. And one night, the cat came through the escape hatch, landed on my sister and frightened her to death. It was not a very happy experience down there, because it used to flood when they're in the winter, because it was built into clay. My father used to get up every hour to pump it out.
And down in the West Country, actually on the north coast of Devon, very little happened in the way of bombing or anything like that. We had one night when a plane, wanting to lose all its weight, dropped a string of incendiary bombs, and one 25-pounder which missed the town gas station. My father, who was a sergeant in the specials, was coming off duty and suddenly found himself walking uphill on a flat road, which turned out to be the edge of the crater of this one bomb, which, as I say, missed the gasworks.
We shall fight on the beaches, we shall fight on the landing grounds, we shall fight in the fields and in the streets, we shall fight in the hills, we shall never surrender.
Took up, well, whatever it was, he wanted to learn to drive tanks and things. Like lots of young boys thought it was all exciting in them days, didn't they? And he went to, they sent him up to Catterick to train as a tank driver. And if you go to Catterick today, you can understand why they use it for a tank thing. It's all open, barren land with all these ups and down hills and everything else on it. I went to see it about 3 or 4 years ago. And from then on, after he'd done his training, the next thing, he was, like a lot of them, brought back down to Broome Park near Canterbury, ready to go on this battle with the D-Day things. But of course it was all hush-hush. And he didn't, his family didn't even know what he was up to or where he was going. And the D-Day landings all came up, as you know, and that was 1944. And because then wasn't, they weren't prepared for the D-Day landings, they were there to go in after the First Fleet, because they were Americans and all sorts over. And he was under Montgomery, General Montgomery. Yes, and he wore General Montgomery's same cap badge all the time he was in the army, which is something I'm quite proud of, with the tank on it. If you see any photographs of General Montgomery in the war, he's got this Royal Army Corps badge on his cap, a tank.
Yesterday morning at 2:41 a.m. at General Eisenhower's headquarters, General Jodl, the representative of the German High Command, and of Grand Admiral Dönitz, the designated head of the German state, signed the act of unconditional surrender of all German land, sea, and air forces in Europe to the Allied Expeditionary Force.